Let's talk about the recent polls. In all the recent polls, Trump is far behind. And from a distance, it looks similar to the performances of Mitt Romney, Al Gore, even Gerald Ford. But if you unpack the polls, the truth comes out. NBC loves to tout the polls they conduct with the help of SurveyMonkey. And I always assumed these are polls of registered voters that merely use SurveyMonkey's tools. And I was wrong. The new polls sample consists of SurveyMonkey users who participate in SurveyMonkey Contribute, where those who take surveys either earn a donation for their charity of choice or are entered to win a prize. And SurveyMonkey touts that over 45 million people have used their polls. But they also say, our customers include 100% of the Fortune 100, as well as other businesses, academic institutions, and organizations of all shapes and sizes. So this makes me wonder about the number of baby boomers in their system. That's the second largest voting bloc. How many people my parents and my grandparents' age are using SurveyMonkey? Well, 69% of baby boomers claim that they voted in 2012. Meanwhile, only 46% of millennials, the people very likely to encounter SurveyMonkey, voted in 2012. And additionally, the baby boomers who are likely to use SurveyMonkey may work for the Fortune 100 companies who depend on the broken system Trump wants to change. Or, even worse, they might work for colleges and universities which are known to be, you know, just a little left of center. So, can we say this is a good poll? Well, let's keep going. In the United States, 26% of voters identify as Republicans, 29% identify as Democrats, and a whopping 42% identify as independents. And does the NBC SurveyMonkey poll reflect this? Well, no, not at all. The sample size was 11,480 registered voters. Now that's a good number if it wasn't made up of SurveyMonkey users. 3,451 respondents were registered Republican, 3,974 were registered Democrat, and 4,055 voters were independent. So, in other words, about 30% of respondents were Republican, 34% were Democrats, and 35% were independent. And remember, this country has 13% more independents than they do Democrats. But in this poll, the sample size of independents almost mirrors Democrats. So can we take the poll seriously? Well, you decide. Another poll, similar story, but the other end of the spectrum. I'm talking about the Post-ABC poll. It has an insanely small sample size of just 815 registered voters, meant to measure the pulse of a nation with over 300 million people. However, you gotta give it to them, they were chosen in a more scientific fashion. Random phone calls to landlines and cell phones. But the makeup is skewed even worse. Only 23% of the poll's respondents were Republican, while 33% were Democrats. And remember, there's a 3% difference, little tiny difference, between Republicans and Democrats in this country. But the Post-ABC poll suggests there's a 10% difference. And what's worse, the sample was only 36% independent voters. And again, they're pretending that there are about as many independent voters as there are Democrats, and it's just not true. And, you know, I can go on and on and on and list poll after poll after poll, and you'll see the pattern emerge very quickly. So instead, let's talk about social media. The Gateway Pundit reports that social media indicates a Trump landslide. And this is exactly the opposite of what the lousy polls indicate. They say on Facebook, Trump has about 10,200,000 likes, and Clinton only has about 5.4 million likes. And when the candidates live stream events directly to Facebook, well, one of Trump's recent live stream posts had 135,000 likes, 18,167 shares, and 1.5 million views. Meanwhile, a recent Clinton live stream only had a meager 11,000 likes, 0 shares, and 321,000 views. On Twitter, it's the same story. Trump has 10 million followers, Clinton has 8. Instagram, same. Trump has 22% more followers. Even Reddit, Trump has almost 200,000 subscribers. Hillary has about 24,000. Trump has 700% more subscribers. And for perspective, Hillary for prison has 55,000 subscribers. And finally, an anonymous source who claims to be a recently fired member of Clinton's paid shill team known as Correct the Record recently came forward. And to be clear, nobody has any way of knowing if this is accurate. It could be a guy lying on the internet. It's an anonymous report. But he says, the blanking polls? If what I heard from the Correct the Record Clinton Foundation contact was right, then most of the news polls are cooked if the result doesn't favor Hillary. Lots of money trading hands, because that's all CTR/Clinton Foundation can do. Throw money at problems. There's no strats, meaning strategies, no thinking things through, no trying new things. It's just LOL, bribe them. Sound familiar? Well, I'd say so. So the next time you see a poll that shows Trump losing in a landslide, check the sample size, check the polling methodology. It's not hard to do. It's at the bottom of every article. And the truth will quickly reveal itself.